Let's look at the translation for the exercise for Chapter 1, Part 1. Les méthodes. Now we can translate this as the modern methods. Now there's a good chance in some complete sentence you would just translate that as modern methods. Like you would talk about modern methods of research or something like that. You might not have the word the, but in French we always have the les, which is the plural of le or la. That would be the modern methods. Une détermination structurelle. That is, so here we had, for the first one, the word order, the moderne, the after, but we translate the modern methods. Une détermination structurelle. It's the same thing. Determination, structural, a structural determination. Now, you might not have any idea what that's talking about. That's actually an expression in one of the exercises at the end of the chapter, and even after translating the text, you might not know what it is. But it's talking about how X-rays were used to determine the position of atoms in crystals, which was a huge advancement in science because we could figure out how atoms actually correspond to things in the nature of the of solids. And structural determination is the process by which you determine the molecular structure. I can guarantee you that will not be on your test, unless perhaps you're doing this for physics, but not too many people do this for physics. A spécialiste reconnu is a recognized specialist. Reconnu is the past participle of a verb that means to recognize. So it would be a recognized specialist, and we can kind of see recognized in there. A phénomène bizarre would be a bizarre phenomenon. Now, bizarre could also be translated as strange, and we use the word strange a little bit more often than we use bizarre, so a strange phenomenon would be just as good, maybe even a little bit better, but a bizarre phenomenon certainly works and communicates the idea. Les sciences sociales would be the social sciences. It's all plural. They all have S's there. Une lettre typique would be a typical letter. Typical would be the adjective, and we'd put it in front. Un sujet charmant would be a charming subject. Le gouvernement français. Français is an adjective that means French, so we would say the French government. Now, in French, adjectives are not capitalized, so that's why we don't capitalize it in French, but in English we do. And finally, un cours difficile would be a difficult course, like this one's probably going to be.